Outside, it's a freezing Arctic wasteland. But inside, it's loud, hot, and rowdy. Welcome to the Thunderdome. We're broadcasting live from Centerapolis, Forsyth, Minnesota. The fans are wearing parkas and shorts, ready for the carnage to begin. And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Midway Mutants battle the Purple Mutant Eaters. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, man, I was here on the panel now. You know, yeah.
Hope you got your mutant tailgate buzz on. I know I did. The teams are revving up on the sidelines, and we are ready for some mutant football. Grim Blitzer along with Bricks and Bricks Jr.
Yeah, Grim, I had a little eye-opener myself at the mutant bloodmobile park next to the taco truck outside. Called a lobotomy shot. Raccoon rabies blood and red bull crap. Hoo-hoo!
Yeah, I can tell your mouth looks like a hot shaving cream dispenser.
And the runner is moving crazy fast. Look at the path you've taken up. And he's off to the races. He did it! He scores! And with that amazing run, he burst. The coach isn't liking that call. Ho-ho! His head just exploded. First and offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down in a mile. He just got crushed. Second down and more than the QB would like. And they went to the air and came up big. Third down and five. And he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and ten. First and ten. Oh, look at this guy break tackle. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
In a fight between King Kong and Godzilla, it was a risky throw and the defense made him pay. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaking fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Now, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. it's first and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. That Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
And it's first and 10. I personally think that the ginormous guy is compensating. Oh, man, the offense called a murder ball. Broke free and has open field in front of him. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Pow! With the brain scrambler. It's first and 10. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and 10. Destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb.
Oh, seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? You get my grill, I'll ruin your world. Ruin it.
And it's first and 10. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Second and 3. And that's a pass that went nowhere. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. And it's first and 10. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way.
Man, this guy could teach you a thing or two, Grim.
He's an orc, Bricks. He probably only knows a thing or two.
Hey, probably tell him what you just said.
Yeah, no need for that. Let the man dance. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
It's first and 10. First and 4. And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not going to dance now.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck off. That was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. And the defense gets another pick. Man.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
First and 10. And an 8-yard gain on that one.
Like when Bricks is mom.
Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my Dead Mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
It's first and 10. All week the quarterback said they'd blow up the defense today. He was right. Second down and 10. It counts for a 1-yard gain. That's not going to do it, fellas. Third down and 9. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. First and 4.
Hot one, hot two.
The quarterback had no time to throw, and the defense gets a big sack. I thought the only tie we'd see would be a noose. Instead, they're in a dead heat. Tie game at the end of 1. Second down and 7.
Hot one.
And that's just a great run for a touchdown. And he's dancing like a zonked out jam band enthusiast.
Well, that's how he spent his entire offseason.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters.
Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Nice run for 5 yards. Second down and 5. He refuses to go down. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's 1st and 10. Some good old-fashioned downhill running as he picks up.
I know how they said never hit a man when he's down. It's just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. And the defense gets the quarterback for a sack. Third down and 6. And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. And the offense has only 2 running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips. It's 1st and 10. Oh, the defense must have called a hot potato dirty trick. Well, the offense is down to their last running back. No rest for the weary. The last runner has to suck it up and hopefully not die. 2nd and 3. And it's 1st and 10. This guy's a brick. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. It shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's 1st and 10.
Hot 1, hot 2.
First down! He hit that line the way it rolled up.
And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. It's 1st and 10.
Hot 1, hot 2, hot 8.
Man, he's running like a bull on steroids. That'll be a 1st down. Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites. the dust. And it's first and ten. Still no, it's the sticky ball dirty trick. The defense pretty much turned the ball into a yo-yo of doom.
Did you ever think you'd say that, Grim? A yo-yo of doom?
No, my friend, I didn't. I love this job. Second down and a lot. And he just wrestles him like bricks his balls. He is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. You know, the league used to flag this for excessive celebration. You know, refs really don't want to get too close to the rabid roided-out monsters. And don't even get me started on the werewolves. And here comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and ten. Second down in a very lot. Well, fee-fi-fo-fum.
I'm not finishing that joke.
And he was stuck to him like glue. Third down and long.
Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure.
And the 2-minute warning sounds. Time to get a beer.
Hey, get me one too.
And it's first and ten.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner.
Ah, another interception. Easy, give this guy.
Oh, he just got crushed. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And it's first and ten.
Not one.
Like a freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Grim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. The funeral expenses, that is.
First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
Breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd.
Yay.
See that boot, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
And they line up for the extra point.
Hey.
straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with the...
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
You know, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They had the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Blasted and picks up 7 yards right there. The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Saban Brits' ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
And there's another pick. And like a monkey trying to fuck a... Oh, and he looks like he just saw four... Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
And it's first and ten.
Not one.
And he pounds the ball into the defense, picking up seven. Second and three.
Not one. Not two.
Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. At the end of quarter two, it's a blowout. We now go to our halftime show sponsored by Monsanto Industries, makers of great killer products like Groundup. Use it on pesky weeds or neighbors, and they'll be gone by morning. The third quarter is about to begin, and if it's as much of a blowout as the first half was, we may see a riot in the stands.
Well, that's going to happen either way, Grim. It's a $1 Red Bull Crap and Vodka Jello shot day.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and ten.
Not one, not two, three.
Murphy Brown!
What?
I mean, first...
It looks like we've got a penalty here. The offense is down to their last running back. If they lose him, they lose all their running plays. And it's first and ten.
Not one, not two, not three.
It's 2 yard run before he stopped. And that'll be second and eight to go.
Not one, not two, not three.
The defense called a good heads up play there, getting it out of bounds. Better than throwing a pick. The offense has only one quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over.
This new QB, he don't even look too confident. He's pleading with the coach on the sidelines about something.
Yeah, he's telling his coach to punt. What a pussy.
Second down in a mile. Third down and never gonna happen. The defender says, I don't think so. And they'll line up for the punt here. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get it. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a dog named Snag.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and 10. Picks up about 6 on the play. And that'll be second down and 4. Does the QB know which team he's on? Oh, great tackle! When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a cop wasn't home.
It's first and 10. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time. And the Purple Mutant Eaters just made the competition today and deliver their home team fans a forfeit.
Grim, some of the defensive Mutant Eater players are snapping on the left of the body parts.
Why do you think they're called the Purple Mutant Eaters, you idiot?
There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. An alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game. How about if you
shut the hell up right now? We go down to the field and listen to what the MVP has to say. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the MicroHard Corporation. They get it right every up.